Well, we've put Julian Clary on ice for half an hour and set free Adrian Edmondson and John Gordon Sinclair.
And our main story this morning of May 15th, 1999. At a special press conference, King Charles has flatly denied rumours that he intends to convert to Catholicism. I'm a devout Buddhist and intend to remain so, he told our reporter. And now for this week's episode of Snakes and Ladders.
I'm just back from an extensive tour of the Brazilian rainforests. It took 3 minutes.
Go talk to your plants, Pinko. Charles is king, the century's over. The north is on the skids, the south is in clover. There's a hole in the sky where the sun's been through. Better put on your hat or it'll burn up you. Cause the ozone's gone and the seas are high, and the winters are hotter than a deep fat fryer.
Hardly anybody has to live in a cardboard box, and people leave their cars without putting the wheels in the boot first. The firm have put me up in a hotel suet.
Suet?
S-U-I-T-E.
Oh, that's suet right enough. Must be a southern word.
Hotel suet in the fanciest hotel you've ever seen, if you've ever seen a hotel, that is.
Never mind that. Why hasn't he sent his bed and board?
He doesn't live here, that's why.
That's no excuse, tight wee louse.
Well, if this Gavin isn't a head office spy, then what is he?
Don't keep going on about him, Ralph. He's just an ordinary management trainee. Probably.
And why is he staying at the Whitelaw Hotel at the company's expense? And he must be loaded. They told me the other night he had a £500 prostitute.
In that case, I'm saving you £200 a minute.
When I asked the computer who he was, it threatened to tell my wife that we were having an affair. It isn't right.
That's what makes it so exciting.
I mean, Gavin. I'll tell you what I think. I think the computer's told head office about us, and they sent this Gavin down to dig the dirt on me so they can give me the sack.
Oh, God! I tried your office, Mr. Haverty, but your secretary said I'd probably find you in her. In here. Are you okay, sir? You look a funny colour.
Mr.
Haverty is having trouble with his blood pressure. If you wouldn't mind stepping outside for a moment.
Okay. He's awfully red in the face, nurse. Don't you think you should try loosening off some of his clothing?
I'm practicing for the Magic Circle AGM, if it's any business of yours. Thank you, Mrs. McLean. I'll see you next tea break.
You're a member of the Magic Circle, are you? You don't think there's any way you could get Mr. Pym to disappear, is
Mr.
there?
Mr. Pym is one of our most valuable employees, unlike yourself.
Mr. Pym is a social orangutan.
Naturally, it's his job description. He's unpleasant to everyone. There's nothing I can do about...
Shoo!
Ta-ra!
Terrific.
Yeah, well, it's better on stage with the music, lighting, dry ice.
Look, I have been here now for almost a week. I know absolutely everything there is to know about manual labour. I'm getting on fabulously well with the working class. And I think it's about time I moved onwards and southwards.
You stink!
Well, I can't help it. I've been sleeping rough in Ridleyville for the past 4 nights.
Ridleyville? Out! Out!
I had no choice!
I don't care, out of my office!
Just don't take European Express up
here! Ridleyville. No self-respecting robot would even be seen dismantled there.
Well, it's all right for you. You've got a nice warm cupboard to sleep in.
Yes, I'm awfully lucky. The thing is, I think I know of a place you could rent.
What? Where?
833 Rifkind Heights, Heseltown.
Heseltine? I've heard of Heseltine. It's voted the vilest piece of post-war housing 7 years running.
It's the only thing that's going.
Oh, look, I wasn't being choosy, honestly. Heseltine! Fantastic!
We educated types must demonstrate a modicum of solidarity.
Can't you read, boy? There's a sign on the door saying knock and wait.
Well, I'd finished waiting. I thought you might have finished knocking.
All right. What do you want?
Well, there wasn't a pay packet for me, so I thought I'd come and ask if there's any chance of a sub, or I won't be able to eat at the weekend. And I'm beginning to quite like the taste of real food.
We can't pay wages without authorization from head office.
Well, do you think you could check with the computer, please?
No. Why should I?
Go on, Ralphie. The poor boy looks hungry.
Oh, okay, well.
Greg, excuse me. Only I wondered, could there possibly have been an error re-wages for Alexander G. Sinclair?
I don't make mistakes. He's on monthly pay, not weekly.
Any chance of an advance, pal?
Talk to the computer like that.
Sorry.
Don't do that again. I authorise an advance of 1 week's pay, £1,153.84.
Brilliant.
How much?
Nurse, syringe Mr. Haverty's ears out. If you're going deaf, Haverty, you may have to sack yourself.
If you don't need me, I think I might go and do a little bit of shopping.
£1,100 a week.
That's more than you earn.
I know.
He is from head office. I'm going to get to the bottom of this. Have you got any of that truth drug left in the interview kit?
Sorry, what's your poison, Gavin? We've got most things.
Oh, I've heard whiskey's quite nice.
Ah, Scotch, right you are. Of course, being Scottish, you'd have a keen appreciation of the water of life. I don't suppose you've ever tasted Glencardner, have you? They only produce a few thousand bottles a year.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Ugh. Very nice.
Oh, by the way, you don't mind me calling you Gavin, do you? Gavin.
Well, actually, I'd prefer it if you called me Dirk.
Oh, sorry, I thought your name was Gavin. Dirk.
Well, it is. But I've always wanted to be called Dirk.
Why?
Well, it's so sexy.
So, how was head office last time you were up there?
I've never been to head office.
No, of course not. I suppose company spies are based in some shadowy outpost.
Well, that makes sense. So, how long have you been slipping it to Nursie?
It's working.
What's working?
No, the microwave, I can hear it humming. It loves music.
Don't mind me saying so. Your sense of humour's like King Charles's hair. Non-existent.
All right. Who sent you to spy on me, Dirk?
What?
Was it Clamp from Regional Accounts? Oh, maybe it was Dodgin from Stores.
Good evening.
Hello, Ralph. Edward and Daphne Gershwin, this is Gavin Sinclair, young high flyer.
How do you do?
How do I do what?
The Scottish sense of humour is a closed book to me. Gavin, I don't think you've met my daughter, Yana, have you?
Hello.
No. I'm sure I would have remembered if I had. You've got lovely breasts. Legs aren't too bad either.
There's a young man who speaks his mind. It's just what our company needs to repel the tide of cheap African imports. Is it a snifter? Anyone? Yana?
Oh, which reminder of? I've got something special for you. It's only from Nexco's, but the liquor buyer, who's a friend, says that it's exactly the same. Thank you, dear. Exactly the same as your famous Glencardner.
Impossible.
Well, I can't taste the difference.
Glencardner is unique. I mean, the smoky peatiness, the limpid clarity.
Well, why don't you try a comparison test, Daddy?
Good idea. Oh, you're out of Glencardner.
Yes, our young guest here had the last of it.
Well, you can have mine, Mr. Haverty. I don't really like this. It tastes like cat's pee.
Well, that should make the test easier, Daddy.
Ah, thank you, Anna. Now, you turn your back, Ralph. Go on. You're not going to cheat on this. Right. Now, here's your limpid clarity. Here's your unique smokiness. Which one is it, eh? Huh? Go on.
Two. Oh, I just heard my wife probably having trouble with her artichokes.
Daphne! Lovely smell. Wish I had the nerve. Edward. Now, have you met Ralph's young friend, Gavin?
Indeed we have. Is the boy all right in the head?
Yes, good.
Ralph Derrick, darling.
Cherry.
Ralph?
No, so Edward, how's the wholesale butchery game?
Oh, don't talk to me about game. I hate this time of year. In fact, I'm going off the whole pheasant plucking business. You're trying to sidetrack me, aren't you? Well, you're not getting out of this whiskey tasting as easily as that. Which is it? Come on now. Come on. Come on.
All right, Edward, exactly the same.
Oh, don't be stupid, Ralph. How can you compare drinks if you don't try first? Come on.
Silly me.
Well?
Absolutely the same. I think they charge all that money for Glen Carp, though.
Well. Told you so.
Can I have more nuts, Mr. Haverty?
Of course you may, Gavin. Oh, don't call me Mr. Haverty. I'm Ralph to all my friends.
I call him Mr. Haverty.
What does he call you? Moby Dick?
Moby Dick. Ralph, say something.
Well, you're hardly a sylph, are you, dear? We've got 12-wheeled trailer units at work with curvier silhouettes.
He's right. Look at the state of you. No wonder Ralphie's always playing hide the salami with Nursey.
Dad! It's lucky I did first aid in the Thatcher Youth. I shall be filing for divorce in the morning. In the meantime, shall we go through?
Through what?
To the dining room for dinner, you stupid, uneducated Scottish breedpo!
Dinner? And what have I just been eating?
These are just a few nibbles to make you feel at home.
Well, I felt at home the minute Ralph threw up in the carpet.
Our prize presents Smash Hits Party 89. Massive chart-topping hits from Sonia, Holly Johnson, Adiba, Milli Vanilli and Big Fun. Top chart smashes from Beautiful South, Kylie and Jason and Transvision Band. Party on down to your local Our Prize for a shattering selection of smashing music.
Roll the camera. Check energy. Get ready, everybody, and action!
Special guest, Villiche, with double action and charge level indicator. The perfect performer.
This place is kind of empty.
Not for long. The Greyhound from Tulsa will be here any minute.
Can't close up early, can you?
No.
Come on, Lucy.
This little Pepsi here must be the next one.
In America, a cola by any other name just isn't the same.
Going on holiday, are we?
No. It's a life insurance policy.
Aren't they normally called boredom?
Ah, but I can change freedom as my life changes. If I get married or...
Single, eh? Tell me more.
Here. Come see for yourself.
Going on holiday, are we?
No, it's a life insurance policy.
Dial 100 and ask for Free Phone Freedom Life Insurance from Guardian Royal Exchange.
No, rien de rien.
de rien. Car ma vie, car mes joies, aujourd'hui, ça commence avec toi.
You'll never regret buying Hitachi.
Look again, I can see, of course, that they are yours. Such a splendid fit. Genuine mistake, I am sorry.
Granted.
You.
Have a fish-flavoured Fergie.
Yum, yum, my favourite. Oh, Robbie! Do you know the way to Heseltine?
Heseltine? You know, found somewhere to stay, have you?
No. I've just got to take a message from work. I thought I might need a bodyguard.
All right, £10.
Five.
20.
Done.
Fine. Right, get your clothes on. Oh no, someone's stolen them, haven't they? Right, come on. Hold on a sec. Hey, this is Robbie. There's no one in at the moment. If you'd like to leave your name, number, and time of call, I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Bye.
Here's my lift. Oh, well, when I say my lift, I don't mean it actually belongs to me. You know, I have to share it with other people. But that's okay, usually, because we always seem to be going in the same direction, you know, up or down. I apologise to your mother for me, she seemed a bit upset. And your dad. And thanks for giving me a lift home.
Look, Gavin, I don't have to go home right away, you know.
What about the curfew?
This is the southern sector. Why don't you ask me up to your room for coffee or something?
Could I?
What if you want? Unless you're some kind of rubber freak who likes being battered by lift doors all night.
Oh, you've spotted my little weakness.
Funeral, of course.
There's no coffin.
Well, he's lucky enough to get a funeral. Most people just chuck their dead on the rubbish chute. Come on, curfew's in 5 minutes. Wait, hold on. Good evening, sir. My name's Robbie. I'm collecting on behalf of the homeless.
Thanks, Robbie. I'll be all right from here.
No sweat. What number is it anyway?
I've forgotten. Look, I've got it written down, sir. Why don't you go back to Ridleyville before the curfew squad?
Look, if you're running a message, you'll need an escort back.
No, they said I could stay just for tonight.
Well, unless you're no coming back at all. Unless you're filming the roof and no giving wee Robbie fast refusal, huh?
No, please help. All right,
£15 then.
What for?
For not letting me take you to your destination. You're in breach of your contract, pal.
If you've lost your key again, you can go and sleep in the lift as usual.
Madam, let me assure you...
We've already got the Encyclopedia Japonica, all except for Tolstoy to Venereal, because we ran out of toilet paper.
Look, I'm not selling anything. On the contrary, I rather hoped you might have something you could rent to me.
You cheeky wee devil. That was years ago. Anyway, you shouldn't listen to gossip.
All right, then. Quick,
before my husband gets home.
Oh, good grief, no. I meant I heard you had a room to rent.
The poll tax, Paulus. I should have known.
No, this... I'm with International Entirety. A robot there said you might have a spare room.
Oh, you shouldn't believe everything a robot tells you.
Oh, so you haven't got a spare room.
£50 a week.
You have got a room? £50? That's very reasonable.
70 then.
70, fine, thank you.
You're welcome. Silly me.
Hey! Don't let her in!
He's a bugger.
He'll take everything.
What are you talking about, you drunken old sot? We haven't got anything. Anyway, look at him. He couldn't mug a wet tea bag.
I'm telling you, woman, I was coming back from the wine lodge when this hooligan attacked me, him and his accomplice. A great giant of a man with a kilt and three pair of trousers and five shirts and four woolies, and a laugh at you and Paisley.
Oh, come away with you, you useless bag of jobbies.
You can't treat me like this. I'm the dole winner.
Microchipping Sodbury at night is so romantic. I love the amber glow of the nuclear fuel reprocessing plant.
Cannot. You know, it must be one of these keys. The first time you try to use it...
What does it matter? Coffee's fine.
No. You wanted brandy? Brandy you shall get. Room service. Yeah, I'd like four large double brandies up here straight away, please. Right. Thank you. Room service is closed down for the night.
Never mind, Gavin. You were ever so masterful.
Yeah, I was a bit, wasn't I? You know, I think I'll make a cup of tea. I've been feeling a bit peculiar all night.
Well, that's because Daddy put a truth drug in your whiskey.
What? Why?
Well, so that you would tell him what your secret mission really is.
What secret mission?
Oh, come on, Gavin. Well, you don't really expect me to believe that one day you were a hopeless doughboy. And the next, a high-powered executive trainee staying in a £400-a-night hotel suite.
No. Actually, when you put it like that, I don't really believe it myself.
Then tell me your secret.
All right. Every night before I go to bed, I get a cucumber and slice it up really thin, cover my face in it. And when I wake up in the morning, my skin's as smooth as a newborn baby's bod.
That's not funny, Gavin. I thought you liked me. You said you thought I had... fantastic breasts and wonderful legs.
Oh, yeah, well, that must have been the truth drug.
No, you were telling the truth. Oh, come on, Gavin, you can tell me. Look, Daddy's promised to buy me a new car. If I can find out what you're really doing down here. So please tell me.
Oh, right. It's true. I am a company spy. Head office suspect that your father's embezzling money and using it to buy expensive rubber underwear. Oh, he's buying his mistress presents as well. And if I can get enough evidence, they're going to fire him and send him to jail.
Oh, no, not Daddy. Well, how awful.
You must love your father enough alone.
Well, that pervert. He must be joking. And if he goes to jail, he won't be able to buy me a new car. Look, Gavin, you mustn't betray him. It's not his fault. It's that nurse. He's in her power. It's the surgical gloves.
Ugh.
Look, if you promise not to tell head office, then I'll stay the night. Well, don't you want me to stay the night?
Yes, but
what?
Oh, it's just that the last girl that stayed the night charged me £500.
I can't find the bath.
It's easy. Go down the lobby, turn left at Give Us Back the Vote, straight ahead for We Demand Free Beer Now, and it's about 4 miles up the dual carriageway.
You mean you don't have a bath?
Certainly not. I'll have a bath every month whether I need one or no. If you want me to scrub your back...
I thought you just said you didn't have a bath.
We don't. Oh, what a very nice body. Gentle.
That was fantastic. You are amazing.
I'm glad you're so easily impressed.
Could we do it again?
Gavin, we've tried 7 times already and it's never lasted more than a minute and a half.
Well, I've only been playing for 2 weeks.
Do you think we could put the chessboard away and have sex now?
Well, if you think we've had enough foreplay.
Well, we could have, perhaps, one glass of champagne.
Sinclair.
How the bloody hell did you get in here?
Never mind that. On the 2MQB training program, carnal knowledge of a fellow employer's daughter is expressly forbidden. You will be fined 2 weeks' salary, and I'm telling your father.
Down the snakes and up the ladders, I don't like this game. You can stop the next millennium, tell me who's to blame. Up the snakes and down the ladders, tell me what you need. And exit visas, do I have to plead? I've seen the future, and it stinks. There's a hole in the sky where the sun's burned through. Better put on your hat or it'll burn up you. The ozone's gone, the seas are higher, and the winters are hotter than a deep fat fry. St. Paul's has drowned, there's only the dome. You need flippers and a snorkel if you want to go home. The channel is covered by you. Slick, you can walk to France, it's 10 feet thick.